hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to carve a message into the side of a rock wall. I provided this image for you to download so you can follow along. Its link is located in the video description or project files. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, click this icon or press D on your keyboard. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. I'm using Abaddon Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. For this font, I'll start with a temporary size of approximately 140 points, sharp, center alignment, and black for its color. Click on your document and type out your text. I'm typing We Are One in Latin. To adjust its size, double-click on the large T to highlight all your text and go to Window and Character. The character panel will open. Drag the size icon to the right or left to increase or decrease its size. To adjust the space between the lines of text, drag the leading icon to the right or left. To adjust the space or kerning between two characters, click between them, hold down Alt or Option, and press the right or left arrow keys on your keyboard. To close the character panel, click the double arrowhead icon. To center the text on your document, open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select it all, and click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Let's convert the text into a smart object, so if we decide later to change the text or even the font, we won't have to redo all the effects. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. You know it's a smart object if you see this icon on the thumbnail. Double-click the thumbnail to open the smart object. We're going to add a simple frame around the text. To do this, go to Image and Canvas Size. Change the inches to percent, and in the width and the height, type in 10 to make the canvas size 10% larger all around, so we have enough room to add the frame. Let's find the exact center of the document. First, go to View and make sure Rulers and Snap are checked. If they aren't, just click on them. Place your cursor on the left ruler and drag out a guideline to the center. It'll snap in place because we have Snap checked. If you don't see the guideline, press Ctrl or Command H. Drag out a guideline from the top ruler to the center. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool, go to the crosshair of the guidelines, click and hold your mouse or pen, and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag out a rectangular selection around your text. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. In this layer, we'll add the frame. Go to Edit and Stroke. Make the width 10 pixels and the location inside. Click OK and then deselect it. Go to Image and Trim. Tick Transparent Pixels and click OK. The Trim command trimmed away the excess transparent pixels surrounding the frame. Now it's cropped right up against the frame itself. Click the small X on the right of the Smart Object tab, and when you see this warning, click Yes to save the changes. The next few steps will be to make the text conform to the irregular surface of the rock wall. First, click off the eyeball of the text layer to hide it, and make the background active. Make a copy of the background by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 2 pixels and click OK. We'll use this blurred background for our displacement map which essentially distorts the text to the background's tonal values. Displacement maps generally give better results when they're slightly blurred. We'll save the blurred background layer by going to Layer and Duplicate Layer. Open the document list and click New. Type in Displacement and click OK or press Enter or Return. Go to File and Save As. Save the displacement map to your desktop for easy access as a Photoshop file. Then click Save. If you see this warning, just click OK. Now we can close the displacement file by clicking on the small X icon on the Files tab. Now that we saved the blurred background copy as the displacement file, we can trash the layer that we used to create it. Make your text visible and active. Change its blend mode to soft light. Click the FX icon and choose Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel. For the technique, I'll use smooth, but feel free to experiment with chisel hard or chisel soft. Tick down for the direction. Check contour and click OK. Go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. Make the horizontal and vertical scales 10, stretch to fit, and repeat edge pixels. Then click OK. Click the displacement document and click Open. Notice your text and its frame instantly conform to the rock surface. If you want to change or edit your text and border, you can do it without having to start over because we save them as a smart object. To do it, double-click on the thumbnail of your smart object to open it. Double-click the large T on your text layer to highlight your text and type out your new words. If you want to bring the frame in closer to your text, make the frame layer active and open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to the middle of a side, and when you see a horizontal double arrow, press and hold Shift and Alt on Windows, or Shift and Option on a Mac, as you drag the Transform in. Then press Enter or Return, or click the check mark. Click the small X on the Smart Object tab, and when you see this warning, click Yes to save the changes. Instantly, the new text and border were updated. Next, I'll show you how to angle it and give it dramatic lighting. Make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Zoom out by pressing Ctrl or Command and the minus sign on your keyboard. Open your pen tool and choose Path. If you're using an earlier version of Photoshop, this is the icon for the Path tool. Click outside your document approximately here. Release your cursor and click approximately here. Continue until you've made a path approximating this shape. When you're back to your first point, you'll see a small circle. This indicates that your path will close once you click. Open the Paths panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Paths. Click the icon at the upper right corner and click Make Selection. Feather it 40 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. Open back up your Layers panel and click the Adjustment Layer icon. Click Levels. A layer mask automatically appears next to the adjustment layer. The shape inside the layer mask was created from the selection we just made. Invert it by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Click the Levels icon and drag the output white to the left to darken it. Make a composite snapshot and open your Transform tool. Go to a bottom corner and hold down Ctrl-Alt-Shift on Windows or Command-Option-Shift on a Mac as you drag the corner out to an angle you like. Then press Enter or Return. To see your document at 100%, press Ctrl or Command 1. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.